Good afternoon, friends. Welcome back to the teaching planning. This is Abdul Yafur with Pedagogy lesson. We see the Pedagogy standard 4-1, lesson 10. In this lesson, I'm going to share and discuss the information about the family, professional, and communication. So what are the bullet points of this lesson before the explanation? I'm going to explain to you the positive and the professional relationship. Stakeholder, what are the stakeholders, and what is triangular system in education? What is the reciprocal communication strategies, that how parents and teachers or a school has to communicate, the way of communication, okay? What are the fundamental developmental programs of the developmental appropriate practices, which is I have discussed in my previous lesson. In this lesson, I'm giving to you the 5 fundamental programs and what is the rank of the reciprocal communication and more. Okay, so let's see, guys, what is talking about the standard 4 and domain 1. So standard 4 and domain 1 has weight of 10%, which means the 10 questions you have to face from it. So these 10 marks are, again, very important, and you have to be very careful. What are you going to do? You must know the information, these practices, while you are on the floor, means on a school. So, guys, please, before the explanation, if you didn't subscribe to Teaching and Learning, so press the subscription button. If you want more videos like that, press the bell icon button. I'll suggest you share these videos with your colleagues, friends, and teachers that they can benefit. As I have mentioned, that I'm trying to upload as much as videos that you can benefit from it. So I'm working on both ECD pedagogy and especially math specialization. I'm receiving requests for the English, so I'll try my best to, at least I can drop a few videos or upload a few videos for the English specialization. So let's see what is the standard 4 and domain 1. I'm going to share the screen now. As you can see the screen. So overview about the standard 4 and domain 1. Early child teachers have a positive professional relationship with children, parents, and colleagues. So means the atmosphere you have to create, a learning atmosphere, a sustainable atmosphere that every teacher has to provide a positive behavior, positive attitude. So as you can see that my previous lesson about the interpersonal skills and intrapersonal skills. So you have to be focused on this. So this positive attitude means interpersonal and interpersonal skills. So you have to focus on these two things, okay? That what are the characteristics of them? And the members of the local communities, that who is visiting to you? Either he or she is a parent or the member of the community. When they are visiting to your faculty, you have to be very positive and give them a very professional relationship in order to attract and give them a warm welcoming, that how we are treating and behaving when somebody is going to be visiting to them. What is that? Why it's happening? Because this is allowing that what is the environment of your school? This is allowing and the development of students are learning. This is allowing to the attitude and language and what we call the behavior of the stakeholders. So each and every staff member has to reflect positively with the colleagues, parents, children, and other community members. Okay, I'll tell you the stakeholders. So stakeholders and triangular systems. The center of school's learning are the school, or sorry, they are the students, okay? That's a significant part or one of the very important stakeholders. So without that, a school wouldn't survive, okay? So we can create two triangulars. So here you can see students, principal, and teacher. This is one of the triangular for the learning, okay, education. Then here, students, here you can say that the school and parents. So parents, students, and administrations and the doctors, shareholders, these all are the examples of the stakeholders, okay? Because they have a benefit in their school. Some has the financially benefit and other one has, you know, the services benefits, okay? So students, what is the benefit of the students learning? Regardless of, you know, the other, the benefits, okay? The most important thing that the student is the center of the learning. So in this family and professional relationship, what the school has to do, a student, a school has to make a center of the environment. Parents must be the center of the environment. So this is what exactly the standard is talking about. Now in domain one, early child teachers are held accountable for communicating information concerning the learning process to the family and the community. What is the role of the teachers in this? They are responsible because they are the front men. Who is mostly communicating with their parents? Teachers. So the teachers are the responsible to reflect positively and they demonstrate the correct information about their children. There should be, they must reduce the gap between students and the parents. They have to communicate with the community positively because the attraction and the semblance of the schools is very important because that is the identification of that school. So teachers are accountable, are the identification of the each and every schools. Well, they are dealing with the students, then they are dealing with the parents, then they are dealing with the communities. Actually, they are representing, they are their attitude, they have behaviors and the standards and the benchmarks of the school. So school teachers are the responsible for each and everything. They have a very significant role in the school room. Now, second thing, these performance criteria identify a respectful, a reciprocal communication strategies to engage and support families and communities in young children's learning. So I'll tell you first, what is the respectful, reciprocal communication strategy? I'll be telling you how to engage the parents as well as, you know. So let's see first, reciprocal communication strategy. Actually, in reciprocal community, what we do, we make the center of the environment. We make the parents as the center of the environment. Why we make the center of the environment? Because students must be confident and relaxed when they are in the learning process. So what the teachers and the schools do, they have to reduce the gap between the parents and build the confidence among the students that your parents are independent, that we have integrations, we have a correlation with your parents. So they feel and like a home-based environment, like a, they must feel be familiar with an each and everything that they can enjoy the learning. So reciprocal, the synonym for the reciprocal, it means correlation, center of the environment, independent learner, and interrelated environment. And how they have to communicate, let's see. Now, establishing reciprocal relationship with the families. As I have mentioned, there are the five fundamentals for that. And the reciprocal is the one of the important, okay, relationship with the families. And that is playing a significant role in the students' learning. So these are the five, the fundamental pillars, you can say, or fundamental appropriate practices of the child program, which I have mentioned in my previous, but I didn't mention these five fundamentals. So you have to creating and caring communicator learner, teaching enhanced development learning, constructing appropriate curriculum, assessing children's learning and development. And the fifth one is the reciprocal relationship with the family. So the relationship with the families is very important. What does it mean a reciprocal? Now, reciprocal means a balanced approach between school and family. A balanced approach between school, teachers, and family. A balanced approach between school, teachers, administration, and family. Now, why this balanced approach? Because that will create an environment which let the students feel unconfident. So when your students, when your children are relaxed, unconfident, that will help or that will enhance the students' learning, or that will give the development in appropriate practice of the learning. So creating a respectable and effective balance program should create a family-centered environment in which parent and professional work together to achieve the shared goal. So you can call the parents, you can invite the parents in the different activities, you can ask them, you can engage them, you can assign a different activities, because once we say the environment, so you have to make a part of it first. How you can make it a part of it? By letting the parents to participate more in school activities or in a school community. And what are the way of the participating? You can arrange activities, you can arrange get together, you can arrange cultural days, you can arrange a meeting, PTM, you can discuss the report, you can discuss the program, you can give them a volunteer approach, you can create a parent portal community and ask them to give you a suggestion that how they can improve. So there are the different reciprocal means and which reduce the gap between school parents or between the community and teachers. Okay, so these are the reciprocal means of communication. Let's see the further how to engage parents. So these are the ways which I have mentioned, and I'll be sharing the description, these same things in the link, and that link is very suitable for that. So I'll suggest you to go through for the further detail and information for that. How to engage the parent. Establish open communication the first time you meet a family. Demonstrate that you value getting to know each family. Keep each child the focus of your relationship. Ask families what they think about all of the aspects of your program. So means you are going to share the methods of assessment, your curriculum, what you offer, how you implement, what is your program. So once the parents are your part of your community or the member of your school, the stakeholders, so you have to be very open. You have to be very transparent to them for each and everything, that why they have to send their children to you, so why they have chosen their school. So this is the first priority, and later on these parents will share this information to the whole community. So at the same time, these stakeholders, they are the publishers, they are giving you more publicity to your schools and what is happening in there. Know your role as an administrator. Strive to be consistent and as firm as possible. Address family concern immediately. So all the matters, you have to be very careful, deal with the care. And if there's a sensitive matter, you have to deal with the parents, okay? By taking care and applying all the code of conduct and taking care of the cultural diversities. Encourage active and engage the family members to project leaders. Assign different activities and different projects. Let the parents participate in activities and give you the feedback. Encourage families to collaborate. So you should advise them, invite them in different parts of the program based on annually, term-wise, daily basis, okay? So if you have a community members in your school or community leader in your school, you have to share this plan and how to lead this plan, that will be her or his responsibility, okay? So guys, this is about the standard four and the domain four, which is the most important thing, okay? Now, ways of communication, how to communicate or we communicate with the parents, okay? We provide them report information. We send them newsletter. Even right currently, we create a WhatsApp groups. We email them. We create a web portals for them. We ask them to, you know, in heritage programs, we ask them to participate in what we call arranged activities by notifying them, cultural days, okay, flag days and all these things, inform the families, the children progress, parents, teachers meeting, documents corresponding and reports, giving their report cards and sharing their report cards. by different activities which is subsequently and engage the communities, which I have mentioned about the cultural the programs. So these are the ways of communication, guys. So this was the family, professionals, and community. And I'm sure this is gonna help you. But I'll just tell you that if it is the modern way of the communication, according to standard 4 and the domain, what happens in the previous? So in past, the teachers and the principal and the school only share the report cards. They were just as a stakeholder to know the progress and attainment of their children. But they never had this type of the opportunity to become the member of the school or to become the part of the school community or to become the part of this school family. So this standard and domain is providing a wide range of opportunities and information about that what is the importance of the families, how professionals has to deal with the community and parents. And this domain is the benchmark of it. So all the teachers must know that what are these benchmarks and how to deal with the parents, what is the importance of that one, that you can improve the learning. I hope this will help you a lot in your ACD pedagogy test. We'll be meeting in the next lesson with the new domain and standard. Okay. So till that, stay blessed and suffice. Don't forget to drop nice comments and subscribing and sharing these videos with your colleague and teachers. Stay blessed, it's a safe. We'll be meeting in the next lesson. Goodbye.